Hi guys, welcome back to Abjada. So on January, there was one breaking change that happened in Sveltekit. It is actually this one. So where we had request.origin path query is now request.url. So there will be a URL object that will be available. So that changes few things in multiple places. We'll discuss what they are. So there is a PR that is, you know, that you can refer to. What are the changes that has been done? And also there is, you can look at the releases where that change has been included. So it is in the version next.208. So that is where that change has been added. Now let's see in what places these changes will take place. And also, so you may consider updating your apps with the new things. So there is nothing to worry, because it shows proper error and you will know, you know, how to fix it as well. So I'm going to be discussing the same thing. So I have a latest Sveltekit already installed, and I have the code open here. So I will first discuss the load function, where things may have changed. So load function is inside this context module script. So I'll create a load function here. Load. So here, if you remember, we used to import something called page, and then we also using that, we used to get the parameters, right? So I will return nothing here, and before that we'll try to console log what page is, right? So in this version, in this version of Sveltekit, page object will not be there. So I don't think we'll see anything in the page. So if you see the error message here, you can see that it's been replaced by URL and parameters, right? So instead of page, if you want parameters, you can use params. If you want URL, you can use URL. If you want both, you can do that as well. So I'll just show the URL object first. Let me console log that. Now here, I will zoom this in a little bit. Yeah. So this is the URL object. So it has many things in it. There is something called password and username. I'm not quite sure why, but yeah. So could be useful. And you can get the host, origin and everything, which is useful in case of a request. Now let's see params. Params will be empty, I think, in this case. That is because there is no parameter added to anything. So this can be useful in case you are using a, let's say we have the same thing in a dynamic route. Okay, so let's say id dot svelte. Okay, so let's go here, and yeah, same thing. And I'll have something like something, maybe. Now in this case, I should see it. Let's see. I'm seeing it here. If you look at this, I'll zoom in a little bit. I'm seeing ID something, right? So this is the parameter that. This is the parameter that is being shown there. So yes, so that's one where parameter might be used. And so there is also one more place where we use it, which is the store that we import, right? Import page from stores, right? So if you console.log dollar page, because it's a store, and I'll remove this console. Now if I come back to home page and refresh, and I see this here. Now in that page, we have a URL object and also params as separate things, so that way you can just get dot URL, page dot URL, and that will give you the page URL here. It's the same object which has everything that we saw there. Params also, you can get it the same way. Now another thing is in your requests, right? So let's imagine there is a form and you make a request to some contact endpoint, and there is a button to submit that. All right, I will also create that contact endpoint .js maybe, and here I will have a get function. Okay, now here we usually get the request and we'll return something. Right now we don't have to return anything, let it be like that. We can console.log the request itself, and in this case let's see if we get the request there. Yeah, so we should see it here. I will zoom out a little bit. We have the request here. So if you observe, there is a URL object, right? The complete URL object. If I do request dot URL, previously it wasn't there. So if I go back here and you see the URL object, the same URL object that we saw in the load function or in the page stores. So those are the changes that has happened. So if you have these in your code, you might want to upgrade along with the upgradation of Sveltekit, so that way nothing breaks in your app. And finally, one more thing is one of my series on WordPress, Sveltekit WordPress headless blog, has been highlighted. That's a nice thing. So yeah, I hope this was helpful, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.